Hello friends, welcome back. In this session, we are going to learn quickly about the sensors which are used in an aeroplane. This is a very interesting topic, not only for aeronautics engineers or mechanical engineers who are working closely with aeroplane, but also for anybody who is passionate about aeroplanes. When I started doing this topic, I learned a lot of new stuff which is very amazing, and I thought I can share it with you in this session. Overall, these are all the fundamental sensors that are used in the aeroplane that is being displayed right now in front of you. I'm going to read it through one by one. Then I will talk about each and every section of it for about 5 minutes. That will give you some idea about where do we deploy these sensors. Now, if you see here, this is called a trailing cone. And we have thermostats used in the flight to a larger extent. Drop zones. This is something very important. I'll explain this a little later. We have cabin pressure, acceleration, monitoring of power supply, cabin temperature monitoring, all these done. For each and every cabin, it is being properly done. And the cabin pressure is very important because if it drops down, you will start bleeding when you fly. Door slides and push-in sensors for the doors, all these are very important. And sealed switch is also used from the doors and the slide side. The radar altimeter is used very importantly in any flight. And the humidity sensor, temperature sensor, pressure sensor, these three will be connected together to understand the environmental situation and the environmental data for a flight to fly. For example, I need to know what is the pressure, what is the humidity in the surrounding. So those sensors are used in this area. And we have got something called as nose boom. It is called as nose boom, and it is used for turbulence measurement. When you fly at 35,000 feet, if the temperature really goes bad and if the climate really goes bad there, you will have turbulence. The turbulence will have to be measured, and this nose boom will help you in measuring turbulence. And we have got something very important called as RVDT and LVDT. What is RVDT? RVDT is a rotary variable differential transformer. LVDT is a linear variable differential transformer. A rotary variable differential transformer is used for measuring angular displacement, but LVDT is used for measuring linear displacement. That's all. I need to measure the displacement, and it is from angular perspective I need to measure. So for that, I need to use RVDT. I need to measure it from linear perspective, so I need to use LVDT for it. Now, this having done, we have done this. We have just seen a very important set of sensors that are used in the flight. Listen to this point. This is just a gist of what are being used. There are so many other sensors which are also missed out. Now I'm going to go deeper into the environmental aspects of how exactly the sensors are used for environmental control stuff. The pressure sensor, pressure switch, temperature sensor, thermostat, nose boom. All these are used for environmental control operations. I need all this data to make sure that the flight is safer and to understand the environment surrounding the flight. It is at 35,000 feet or at the ground. I need to measure them carefully. So all these are done with environmental control sensors. Now, engine support. I have got LVDT, speed measurement sensors, thermostat, and many more are connected to engine support. If you go deeper into engine sensors, we use speed and torque measurement sensor, temperature sensor, the oil system monitoring, the ice detection and protection system. Why is this needed? When I fly at 35,000 feet or above, the wings and every part of the flight, I mean the external surface, could get iced. So when it is getting iced, it has to be de-iced. For it to be de-iced, I need to measure if the ice level is okay to fly or it has to be immediately de-iced. So I need to go with that. And temperature sensor and the air temperature sensors are being used as well. So all this together comes hand in hand for the engine sensor part. And this is called engine support section of the topic that we are discussing. The next one is landing gears and wheels. Landing gears and wheels use extensively RVDT. RVDT, as I told you, rotary variable differential transformer, the speed sensor, the position sensor, the thermostat, the brake torque sensors, and center of gravity force sensors. These come into picture with respect to landing gears and wheels. All these sensors are extensively used for someone to land the flight perfectly. Now, flight deck. Flight deck will have many, but out of that, I'm highlighting few here. Flap selector. The wings will have a lot of flaps, right? So flaps are the ones that goes up and down. So this flap selector is there in the flight deck. Thermostat, precision potentiometer are most importantly used in the flight deck. There are many other sensors as well, but I'm highlighting just the ones that I'm very clear about. Now, what is drop zone? It is a very important and a very interesting title that we can talk about for hours together, but I'm going to give you a brief note about it. A drop zone is an expendable weather device created by the National Center for Atmospheric Research. It is called NCARE, and it is designed to be dropped from an aircraft at an altitude to more accurately measure the tropical storm conditions as the device falls onto the surface. You will drop this device from a particular height and you can understand the storm conditions, I mean the weather conditions, as the device falls onto the surface most accurately. You drop this, you get the data and you understand the storm conditions. This is most importantly used when you fly above the sea. That's it. This session has been very short, but I think I have covered what I wanted to cover. If you have any questions, suggestions, inputs, please go ahead and type it in the comment section. I'll come back with more content and interesting data as well in the near future. Thank you very much for the tremendous support that you guys have been giving me. Thank you.